The reasons why logos are very prevalent in our world, symbols that carry messages, markings that carry messages. It's more of a hieroglyphic type world that we're moving back into. And hence, I said it this morning, I'll say it again, that is why there is such a rise of tattooing in the world. Now watch, as a born-again believer, Pastor Mika will give you his positions. You're an adult, you can make your choices. But as a born-again believer, if this was your history, if it happened before you came to the Lord, I'm not speaking to you, that's not the issue. But if you sit up in the church talking about, I want to get a tattoo, I'm just telling you that that's not the way to go. The markings that are coming in, it's really what it is. It's the enemy perverting the spiritual marking of God. I don't know if you know this, but God is really the originator of tattooing, but he doesn't tattoo us in the natural. You know that, right? Well, I can prove that to you. When Cain killed Abel, God was the first one to put a mark on men. He put a mark on Cain so that anyone, it wasn't a physical mark, but he marked him in the spirit to preserve his life. And God has always been marking his people. In the book of Ezekiel, for instance, Ezekiel has a vision. He says there's a man walking through Jerusalem with an ink horn. Notice, an ink horn. And that man goes through Jerusalem and he puts a mark on every man, every woman that cries for righteousness. And so the enemy comes along and he does the same thing. He perverts it in the natural. And now you can begin to understand why when the Antichrist system comes in, it comes with a mark. Do you understand? So we've got to be wise. And I'm not saying that, you know, Pastor said, the Bible said, I'm just telling you that let us not bear the mark of the enemy on ourselves. If we have the choice to, let us not do those kind of things as born-again believers, because we understand that our responsibility is to give leadership to the world.